Welcome everyone to meditation. My name's Beem, and in this class, we will be going through the basics of meditation. You can say meditation from the ground up. And we will also have a guided meditation. And by the end of this class, you will have everything you need to begin your own meditation practice. This class is also useful for those who have been practicing for a while. So we'll begin. So first of all, welcome. And let me tell you about the philosophy of meditation. And right now I'll tell you everything that you need to know in your practice about the philosophy of meditation, and that is we all have a light. And there's a candle here with a light, with a flame in it, and that light symbolizes our own inner light, our inner light of being. We all have that. And if you're religious, you could say it's the light of God. If you're scientific, you could say it's consciousness. But we all have that inner light. It just gets covered up. It just gets covered up by our anxiety, our fear, our worry, our anticipation about the future, regrets about the past. So the basic philosophy of meditation that's come down for thousands of years is that our practice is to dissolve all the things that cover up our true light. In other words, dissolve all the things that get in the way of us being ourselves, who we really are, without any coverings. So that's the philosophy of meditation. And we have a helper here to remind us to come back to our breathing, and that's the mindfulness bell. And during the class and in future classes, we'll be inviting the bell at different times. And when we invite the bell, it is really an opportunity to just breathe in and breathe out, usually three times, to just come back. And as we invite the bell, you'll hear a small sound in the beginning, and then a louder sound. So now we'll begin with basic instructions for sitting meditation. First of all, find a very comfortable spot. You could sit on a cushion. I'm sitting on a zafu, which is a round meditation pillow that's filled with buckwheat husks. You could sit on a chair. If you have back problems, you could also lay down. But find a very comfortable position, because meditation isn't about struggling to attain something. It's being comfortable and able to drop in to your true being. Relaxing the body, relaxing the mind, relaxing the breathing, being able to drop in to your true being. So you find a comfortable meditation spot and a meditation posture, and that's yoga. Your yoga posture of meditation is something that will become very comfortable to you, and you can always modify it. You may notice that you need to elevate your seat so your knees are more relaxed, maybe put something under your knees, and you can really work with your yoga teacher to help you develop a very comfortable, stable meditation posture. So the ingredients of the posture are, first, comfort. Second, a feeling of stability, like a mountain, that you're sitting like a mountain. Third, in this stability, you're very flexible. So there's a feeling that you're not locked in, but you're here, you're present. And this spot that you're sitting in right now, as you sit in meditation, is your sacred place. So in your home or wherever you meditate, to cultivate a space, to create a space in your bedroom or living room or outside, something that can be a spot that you become very familiar with the energy of meditation when you sit there. Become very familiar with the energy of meditation. In the story of meditation, there is a very, very famous meditation teacher, the Buddha. And the Buddha was a person, was a man. And he decided to sit when he was ready and knew this was the night, this was the time. And he made himself a very comfortable meditation cushion. A boy who was feeding the water buffaloes grass was coming by, and Buddha said, "Could I have some of that grass to sit on so I can have a comfortable seat under this tree?" And the little boy, Shrasti, said, "Sure." And gave the Buddha a bundle of grass. He set it up and he sat down. So in the story of Buddha, the first thing was taking a seat. And the location of that seat, you can travel to in India, in Bodh Gaya. There's the tree that he sat under, a relative of it, and there's the location where Buddha sat in meditation on his night of enlightenment. So as we sit, we're joining this lineage. We're joining this lineage of Buddha, but also millions of women and men from all traditions who have embarked on this journey of going within, of dissolving all the things we don't need and living with that light of our being. They call individuals who are able to live in that light of being enlightened. Enlightened beings in light, living in light. And you may notice when you see pictures of saints, of women or men, they have a halo of light signifying their enlightenment, that they have dissolved the things that weren't them and let their own light shine out. So as we take our seat, we're joining that lineage. And that's why I like to call this class, this first class, meditation from the ground up, from really creating your posture, from sitting, from becoming very comfortable with your posture. And you can see in the picture of Buddha, you can see his hand, and his hand is touching the earth. And he's signifying his connection with the earth. He's signifying that here I am, I'm touching the earth, I'm connected with the earth. As we begin meditation, first we sit, we connect with our body. And meditation, every time, is fresh. We should approach meditation with an open-minded curiosity, like, wow, this is a new moment, it's a fresh moment. What's going on? What's going on inside of me, around me, with my breath, with my body? So we recognize our body, that we have a body. Remember, we have a body. Oh, here I am, got a body. Shoulders, arms, head, legs, stomach. And then we notice, wow, that body's breathing. In-breath, out-breath. And then we notice, of course, there's thoughts, there's feelings going through. Usually, when we want to begin a practice, we may start with the thoughts. Oh, people always ask me, oh, I want to meditate my mind and all my thoughts and everything. How can I deal with that? And we can, definitely. But the way to approach it is from the ground up, in a very simple way. So we'll begin our practice. And as we practice, there's a couple of things. First of all, you can keep your eyes open through the meditation. And if you do, it's helpful to have your eyes slightly closed and maybe focused down. Or you can keep your eyes closed. Or you can keep your eyes closed for a while and sometimes open them. If I'm sitting outside, I may start with my eyes closed and then open my eyes and look around a little bit and then come back and close my eyes. So we'll begin at the sound of the bell. With the sound of the bell, you'll hear three sounds, and between each sound there is a pause or a space for us to breathe all together three times, and then we'll begin the meditation. So breathing in to your body, breathing out, just noticing your in-breath and your out-breath. And in the beginning, you can even say in your mind as you breathe in breath, and as you breathe out breath. Just bringing your awareness, your attention, just back to your breathing, feeling your breath in your body as it moves in and moves out. As you breathe in, feel your breath moving into your whole body, ventilating, creating space. And as you breathe out, just feel that release. Feel your breath moving out into space, dissolving into space. Breathing in, I relax my whole body. And breathing out, I smile gently. I let go. And just check in with your body. Just noticing your posture now. Noticing the position of your feet, of your legs, with part of your awareness on your breath. Just see if you can let your body relax into your posture. Notice the pressure of your buttocks on the cushion or on the chair. Feeling just gravity, just holding you down, connecting you to the earth. Be aware of your abdomen rising and falling. Letting your shoulders relax down, letting go of any tension. Noticing the position of your hands on your lap or on your knees, and just letting your hands, your arms relax. Up through your shoulders, your neck, relaxing your jaw, relaxing your cheeks, relaxing around your mouth, around your eyes. Relaxing your forehead. Feeling your whole body relax. As you relax around your mouth, feel that very gentle half smile. That smile comes from deep inside. It's a smile of your true self. And then just coming back to your breathing, just feeling your breath again moving into your whole body, ventilating, and creating space, lots of space, space inside and space outside, lots of space. Your whole body. As we ventilate with our breath, we're letting things move along. When we get stuck in a difficult or negative mental state, we tighten up. Our breath isn't flowing. And we're not flowing with life. So letting the breath move naturally without forcing it, feeling that sense of space, of openness. Perhaps you would like to visualize yourself just sitting on the bank of a river, a big, beautiful river that's just flowing along. And that river comes from many sources, from the mountains, from lakes, from springs, from the rain, from glaciers. That river is like our mind. It comes from many sources. Our society, our parents, our language, our environment. And just imagine you're just watching that river flow, and you're breathing, and you're relaxing. And you're noticing that there's things floating on the river. In the distance, maybe a boat. Maybe you see some logs or leaves close up. Those are like the thoughts and feelings that are just flowing along. Relaxing your body, feeling just this flow of life in this moment, right now. Feeling space. If you like, you could let your awareness move down to your heart center. The heart center is at the same level as the physical heart. And just breathe into your heart and breathe out from your heart. Just feeling a lot of space, openness. There may be some tender feelings arising, which is natural. Breathing into your heart, breathing out from your heart. If a difficult feeling comes along in meditation, noticing a thought or a feeling, imagine you can breathe it through you. You can breathe into your heart. Let it just move through you. Notice it, not trying to push anything away, but let everything just flow. Just flow through you. And then bring your awareness back to your body. Just feel yourself right here, wherever you are, just connected. And know, by practicing, even a little bit every day, You can transform, rewire your mind, your emotions. You can let your light shine out, dissolve the things that cover up your light. So we'll conclude this meditation practice with the sound of two bells. Thank you. So that concludes our first meditation. And I really encourage you to take a little time and sit every day. And you can just practice even for three breaths, multiple times a day. It will completely transform your mind. That's a thousands of year guarantee that comes down from all the women and men throughout time who've embarked on this path, this inner journey. So I want to thank you. In our next meditations, we'll be exploring developing true love and compassion, transforming difficult emotions, walking meditation, deep relaxation. So, thank you very much.